إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Verily all praise, all thanks are due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His help. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of ourselves and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our sins. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one can misguide. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves astray, no one can guide. I bear witness that there is no God worthy of being worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was his final messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran al-Kareem, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu attaqullaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, be mindful of Allah, have taqwa of Allah, and secure yourself in dying in true submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secure yourself in dying in true submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, when He calls mankind, He says, Ya ayyuhan nas, تَقُوا رَبَّكُمْ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا O mankind, be mindful of your Lord, the one who created you from a single soul. And from that soul created its mate. And from them too created a multitude of men and a multitude of women. So be mindful of your Lord, the one to whom you claim your right, and the one who will question you on the day of judgment, and the one who will question everyone on the day of judgment. Inna Allah kana alaykum raqiba. Allah over us, Allah over you, is well informed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls on the believers again, when he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا يُصْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O man, O you who believe, O you who believe, be mindful of your Lord and only say that which is right. Have taqwa of Allah, which sometimes is translated as fear Allah, and other times is translated as love Allah, but in meaning it means both. To love Allah and obey Him, and to fear Allah and abstain from disobeying Him. So have taqwa of Allah, and only say that which is right. If you do so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us what He's going to do for us. Yuslih lakum a'malakum. Allah will manage your affairs, so no need to worry. And what better? Who better to manage our affairs than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The all-wise, the all-knower, the all-powerful, the merciful. Who better to manage our affairs than Allah? When was the last time we turned to Allah earnestly, with a clean heart, with pure clothing that was earned from pure means, with a full stomach that was filled with pure means? When was the last time that we turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that state, so that He can answer our dua, so that he can respond to our needs? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He will manage your affairs in this dunya, and He will forgive you your sins in the hereafter. And then Allah gives us the ruler from which we measure success. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. Whomsoever obeys Allah and obeys the Messenger of Allah will definitely obtain the ultimate success. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst the successful. Amen. Amma ba'd. Brothers and sisters, the topic is tawakkul. Not tawakkul. Similar, but different. Tawakkul is that you put your trust in Allah, but you sit and wait for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take care of your affairs. Tawakkul is that you put your trust in Allah, but you also take the means. You put your trust in Allah, but you work. You don't just put your trust in Allah and just wait for the provision to come, but you take the means. So brothers and sisters, when we look at our current circumstances, we always have to make personally our stands, right? What is our stands? What is my stand? Or what is the stance of Islam? We have to be very cautious in when we're speaking and giving our opinion as if it's coming from the Book of Allah and the teachings of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If you get caught by surprise and you're going to be interviewed, you ask the interviewer, ask them, do you want my opinion or do you want the Islamic opinion? And if you do not know the Islamic opinion, I do not know the Islamic opinion. Be honest. Because if you say something about Allah or about His Messenger that is not of them, then there's consequences, right? There's consequences. So Islam rejects, as we know, all forms of extremism. Our beloved Prophet ﷺ said in hadith found in Sahih Bukhari, إِنَّ الدِّينَ يُسْرًا وَلَا يُشَادَ الدِّينَ أَحَدًا إِلَّا غَلَبًا. Verily the religion is ease, Whomsoever becomes extreme in the religion will lead him to his own destruction. فَسَدِّدُوا وَقَارِبُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا So seek the straight path. Seek nearness to Allah. وَأَبْشِرُوا Have glad tidings that Allah is going to reward you. Have hope that Allah will reward you. وَاسْتَعِينُوا And seek help. وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالسَّحْوَةِ وَالْغَدْوَةِ وَشَيْءٍ مِنَ الدُّلْجَةِ And seek help in the morning, afternoon, and evening prayer. That's what our beloved Prophet instructed us to do. To understand that Islam is the middle path. And that our first step to seeking help, as it comes in the Quran, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ Seek help and patience through prayer. So that is our first step before any reaction. Because we're inundated with so much media, with so many tragedies, right, that make us concerned. I had a cousin of mine. I haven't spoken to her in 20 years. And she sent me a private message on Facebook asking me, what is the definition of jihad? She said, I feel shy to ask. I feel shy to ask even friends that are Muslim because they might get offended. But you're my cousin. I want to ask you. So she wrote that on a text, on an inbox. So I decided, I said, the best thing is for us to talk on the phone. And we did. Now, my cousin is sharing the posts, the positive posts that are coming out related to the current affairs of the good things that have happened. The Muslims gathered this much money for the victims and the families of the San Bernardino tragedy, and she's sharing it. So these things occur. So we make our stance clear that we are against extremism, bigotry, Islamophobia, and that we understand, yes, matters sometimes are not clear. So leave them unclear. Don't try to come to a conclusion. If it's unclear to those who are investing so much money in investigating, then leave them. Don't place a judgment. Put your trust in Allah. Judge the act. That act is against Islam. Simple. Right? It is against Islam. Is it for Islam? Regardless of who did it. It is an act against humanity. It's an act against humanity. But in the midst of these tragedies, you have people who take advantage of these tragedies to propagate their own causes and incite more fear into the general public. And the ones who suffer the most are the youth. Our youth that have to go to the public schools and have to suffer being called terrorists, extremists. Are you going to bomb the school? I have heard this from the mouth of students just a week ago, before the incident in San Bernardino. Before the incident in San Bernardino, after the incident of Paris, I sat with the youth and had an open discussion with them. And I was amazed at how many of them experienced these challenges. But the question is, who are they talking to? Right? If they're not talking to someone gradually they become affected psychologically. Right? Now sincerely ask yourself, as a Muslim living in this community, can you identify one institution for Islamic counseling? Just one, in the city of Houston. Right? According to standard, both psychological standard and also Islamic standard. Honestly, it's rare to find. Not only in Houston, nationwide. Nationwide. This is the reality. A teacher in Georgia asked a student, do you have a bomb? In Tampa, a Muslim woman was attacked. And there are many, many cases. But there's also good news. There are many efforts like the one that the Muslim community embarked on of collecting money for the victims and the families of the victims, which they collected approximately $175,000 to $177,000. Also, in Georgia also, the Jewish community rallied against Islamophobia in support of the Muslim community. In Canada, there was a mosque that was arsoned. And the Jewish community, a synagogue, opened the doors for the Muslims to perform their prayers. So there's still good people out there, promoters of peace, people who love our community, like the our neighbors from the Unitarian Church in the Bay Area by Click, who welcome the Musallis with signs, in support of the Muslim community. Signs that say Muslims make a better world. Imagine if you face in the morning all this load of news, and then you come to some community members were hesitant to go to the mosque, and then you're welcomed by the neighbor church with signs, taking the time. Nobody's paying them to do it. They're doing it because the relationship was developed between the Islamic Center of Clear Lake and the church. Also, we were blessed to know that one of our Muslim sisters from New York City yesterday was sworn in as the first Muslim woman judge in New York City. And she was sworn in with the Quran. Brothers and sisters, know that we are blessed and we are here for a reason. If this country wasn't what it is, we would not be here. We know the reality of what occurs back home. We love our countries, but there is a sad reality that led us to be in this country and raise our children in this country and provide for our children in this country. right, and be able to establish masajid in this country and schools in this country. And no one prevents us from that. We can propagate Islam, inform people about Islam, and nobody prevents us from that. So we have the freedom to practice our religion in this country. But also, as Muslims, when we're talking to others about Islam, we should also respect their freedom and not try to force them or judge them because of what they believe in. Because Allah is the one that guides, not me or you. Allah is the guide, as He says in the Quran Kareem. So we have the good intention and we dialogue and talk with wisdom, patiently. But show your Islam in your amal. Show your Islam in your actions. Actions speak louder than words. Your kalam, your talk can be beautiful from A to Z. And it can contradict all of your actions, some. And this is what sticks in the mind of the people when they see. This person told me about Islam and then he's over there doing this, doing that. Right? That's the reality. Also justice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ يَعِظُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah enjoins justice, kindness, and giving to the kinsfolk, and forbids indecency. So a Muslim should not be involved in indecencies. A Muslim should not be involved in indecencies and abominations or wickedness. The Prophet ﷺ also said that seven will be under the shade of Allah the day that there will be no shade except His. One is the just ruler. The just ruler. Our children learn in the schools the Pledge of Allegiance. And at the end it says, for liberty and justice for all. Liberty and justice for all. Equality. In Islam we learn, as our beloved Messenger said, O people, indeed your Lord, the Exalted is He, is one. Your Father is one. And there is no superiority of a white man over a black, nor superiority of a black man over a white, except in taqwa, except in mindfulness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We read also in the American Constitution that says, we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal and endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights. And among them are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. This includes us as well. This includes us as well. Brothers and sisters, there is a moment in Jummah when the dua is accepted. أَقُولُ قَالِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُونَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise and thanks are due to Allah. And may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon His final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, His companions and all those who follow Him until the day of judgment. Brothers and sisters, in the midst of all these challenges, local challenges, national challenges, worldly challenges, we have to also do our part. Yes, I mentioned the ayah, seek help in prayer. Seek patience in prayer. What's the ayah? Somebody was salah. But you also have to do some work.
You also have to get involved in your local mosque. You also have to get involved in your neighborhood. You also have to get involved in the public, in the school system. If your children are in the school, get involved. You have to get involved. As a Muslim, if you get involved and contribute, that eases also the hardship. It's not fair to just sit back and complain. And when somebody works, you criticize the one that works. I don't agree with that, but what are you doing? Right? What are we doing? We're sleeping, waking up to work, earning our salary, going back to sleep, drinking our tea, watching some TV, then waking up again, going back to work, and resting. What was the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What did he tell Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha when he received Surat Al-Mudathir? What did he tell her? He said, the days of rest are over. The days of rest are over. That is our beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Measure yourself before you measure. Check yourself before you're checked. Measure yourself, check yourself. How do I guard my salah? How do I guard my reading of Quran? How do I treat my neighbors? How do I treat my customers? You should treat them well for the sake of Allah. And make that mu'amalat ibadah, worship. Bila muqabala, you don't want nothing in return. Right? You don't want nothing in return, like Allah says in the Quran, لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We don't want no reward from you or no thanks. We do it because we have to do it. We are kind because Islam tells us to be kind. We are honest because Allah instructs us to be honest. We pray because we submit to the will of Allah, the Lord of the worlds. And this earth all belongs to Allah. All of this earth, not only one region of the earth, but also America is part of this earth. This globe all belongs to Allah. The Prophet ﷺ, brothers and sisters, before the concluding his salah, used to go down his sujood and make dua. I want you to take this home. I want you to not just take it as something that sounds nice, but try to put it into practice. And try to teach your wives to put it into practice. And sisters, try to remind your husbands as well to put it into practice. Test them. Do you remember this? And if they forgot, remind them. Right? We have to help each other. وَتَعَوْنَ عَلْبِرِ وَالتَّقْوَى. Help each other in righteousness and God consciousness. So the Prophet ﷺ used to say, this is to conclude. He used to say, يَا مُقَلِّبَ الْقُلُوبِ وَالْأَبْصَارِ ثَبِّتْ قُلُوبَنَا عَلَى دِينِكَ. O you who controls the visions and the hearts, make our hearts firm upon your deen. Islam is not my deen. I am a Muslim because this is my religion. La, this is Allah's religion, and we have been favored with Islam. Look at the condition of our countries, of our people before Islam, before the Quran. Let's look back in history and see how Islam tamed us and raised us up and honored us with the Quran, the preserved Quran that we so much neglect, but we quote unquote say that we defend. If you defend the Quran, then you live by it. Bila kalam. If you love the Quran, you live by it. And let Allah do the rest. If you love the Messenger of Allah, the one that Allah chose, you didn't choose. Nobody chose. Allah chose him. If you love the Messenger of Allah, then you follow him. Then you follow his example. You follow his kindness, his mercy, his truthfulness, his compassion. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Ar-Rahimuna yarhamuhumur Rahman." Those who are merciful will be shown mercy by the most merciful. Irhamu man fil ard yarhamkum man fis sama. Have mercy to those who are upon the earth, that the one who's in the heavens will have mercy on you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with hearts that are merciful.
Amen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us, secure our community with protection.
Amen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with bright days, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the best in this dunya and the best in the hereafter. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban nar. Rabbana atina min ladunka rahma wa haylana min amrina rashada. Rabbana faghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina tawaffana mal abrar. Ya muqallib al qulub wal absar. ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم اشف مرضانا مرضى المسلمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا مرضى المسلمين. اللهم اصلح احوال المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم اصلح احوال المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم ارحم موتانا موتى المسلمين. اللهم ارحم موتانا موتى المسلمين. وصلى الله وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. واخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.